Shalom, brothers and sisters. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we welcome you to the third episode of Champions for Christ Youth Program. With delight and joy, let us praise the Lord and hear His word. God bless us through this service. Shall we praise the name of the Lord by singing, Lord, I offer my life to you.
My joy and my pain, I'm making them yours. Lord, I offer my life to you, everything that I've been through. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you. As a pleasing sacrifice, Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. All of my heart, all of my praise, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life.
Let's pray. Loving Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit of God, blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for gathering us in this episode of Champions for Christ Youth Program to praise your holy name and to meditate on your word. Lord, we submit ourselves and open our hearts. Speak to us, guide us, exhort us, and we pray that our lives might be turned around to live as a champion for you. We submit us once again into your mighty hands. In Jesus' name we pray, O Father. Amen. Welcome back, friends. The champion of this episode is Mark, one of the authors of the Gospels. Mark is a significant figure during the time of the early church. He lived in the first century during the time of Jesus and the apostles, and he served the Lord with the apostles like Peter, Paul, and Barnabas. So we are going to explore the life of Mark. Let us see the background of Mark. Mark's full name was John Mark. John was his Hebrew name. In Hebrew, it is Yohanan, which means God is gracious. Mark was his Latin name. In Latin, it is Marcus. Marcus was his surname and the name by which he was well known. So the name of Mark shows that he has a dual background. Mark's mother was a Jewish lady. Her name was Mary. Mark's father was a Roman citizen and he held an office in the Roman government. So Mark had a Jewish background as well as a Roman background. Mark and his family lived in Cyrene, located in North Africa. After his father's death, Mark and his mother came to Jerusalem and resided there. Their family was a wealthy family. Mark's mother built a house where the believers would gather to pray. Peter also came to this house to pray. Acts chapter 12, verse 12. So when he had considered this, he came to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose surname was Mark, where many gathered together praying. In this verse we see John, his surname Mark, his mother whose name was Mary, and the house of prayer which they built, and he who comes here to pray was Peter. So this is the background of Mark. So to explore the life of Mark, let us do it in three stages. The first stage is Mark, the frightened youth. Mark in his youth was a follower of Jesus, but he wasn't a devout believer. He was a secret, silent follower. He followed Jesus and witnessed all his acts until the point of his arrest. Let's read Mark chapter 14, 43, 51 and 52. And immediately while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, with a great multitude with swords and clubs, came from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. Now a certain man followed him, having a linen cloth thrown around his naked body. The young man laid hold of him, and he left the linen cloth and fled from them naked. While Jesus was arrested in Gethsemane, all his disciples fled from him. There was a young man who closely followed Jesus. He only had a linen cloth around his body. When they tried to take hold of him, this young man left his linen cloth and ran away naked. It is said that this young man was Mark. He was a frightened youth at first. He fled from Jesus from the fear of death. But later, Mark believed Jesus and he accepted salvation. This was through Peter. The second stage of his life is Mark, the faithful servant. After he accepted Jesus, Mark served the Lord with the apostles. Mark had the privilege to serve God with Peter, Paul, and Barnabas. Barnabas was Mark's uncle. Mark was his nephew. He joined Paul and Barnabas in their first missionary journey. Barnabas, as Mark's uncle, took Mark to accompany them in their missionary voyage. Mark had the privilege to serve God with elderly and experienced apostles, men of God. In their first missionary journey, Paul, Barnabas, and Mark went to a city called Perga. The inhabitants of that city had a reputation. They were barbaric in nature, violent people. Seeing this, Mark was not impressed by those people. He was either frightened or he disliked serving in that place. Let's read Acts chapter 13, verse 13. Now when Paul and his party set sail from Paphos, they came to Perga in Pamphylia. And John, departing from them, returned to Jerusalem. Mark left Paul and Barnabas in Perga and came to Jerusalem. Either he was frightened by those people or he did not like to serve them, he left them and he came to Jerusalem. This had a bad impression on Mark. In Jerusalem, he served along with Peter for 2 years and he grew in faith. Mark realized that his abrupt departure from Paul and Barnabas was not right. So Mark went back to them he met them in a place called Antioch. Paul and Barnabas were all set to start their second missionary voyage. Upon the arrival of Mark, Barnabas insisted that they take Mark along with them. But Paul strongly disagreed with this opinion because he could not trust Mark, who left them, who had no commitment. This caused disagreements between Barnabas and Paul and caused them to go separate ways. Barnabas took Mark, who had repented, and went a different side. Paul took Silas and carried on with his second missionary journey. So Mark served God with Barnabas. Barnabas accepted Mark, for he repented of his mistake and he trained him in his ministry. Both of them went to a place called Cyprus. Mark and Barnabas preached the gospel in Cyprus, established and built churches in Cyprus. Mark was a very faithful servant when he served under Barnabas. After 11 years, Mark reconciled with Apostle Paul. When Paul was imprisoned in Rome, it was Mark who gave him strong moral support. Paul says in 2 Timothy 4:11, "Get Mark and bring him with you, for he is useful to me for ministry." Paul accepted Mark and involved him in his ministry in the last years of his life. So Mark had the privilege to serve God with Paul also. Mark also served the Lord with Peter. It was Peter who brought Mark to salvation. Peter shared as an eyewitness all the accounts of Jesus to Mark. Mark acted as a secretary to Peter. He was very useful as an assistant in writing for Peter. In 1 Peter 5:13, Peter calls Mark his son. Mark was very dear to Peter. So Mark, even though he was a frightened youth at first, God changed his life and he became a faithful servant, and he served the Lord with Barnabas, with Paul, and with Peter. Mark did not stop his ministry there, but he crossed the Mediterranean Sea. He came to Cyrene, where he was born, and he evangelized to the Jews and the Gentiles who lived there. He preached the gospel to them. He performed miracles and he brought many to Jesus. He also traveled to the city of Alexandria, a place where it was impossible to preach the gospel, a place full of idol worship. Mark did not back down, but with boldness preached the gospel and established a church in Alexandria. Mark raised leaders, deacons, and preachers in Alexandria, and Mark became the first bishop of Alexandria. While in that polytheistic place, Mark met a cobbler who believed in only one God. Seeing his interest, Mark shared the gospel to him. The cobbler believed. His whole household was baptized, and they were added to the church. Later, it was this cobbler who became the second bishop of the church in Alexandria, and his name was Ananias. Mark was the first bishop of the church in Alexandria, and Ananias, whom he brought to salvation, became the second bishop of the church in Alexandria. Mark preached the gospel in such a hostile place. He was not frightened anymore, but he was bold, stood for the cause of the kingdom, preached the gospel, and brought many to Jesus Christ until the point of his death. He was successful in raising leaders, deacons, preachers, presbyters, and bishops, and he established churches. He lived as a champion, faithful servant of God until the point of his death. When Mark preached the gospel in a city called Bacchalia in Alexandria, a city full of idol worship, the pagans in that city were aroused. They resented all the efforts of Mark, who tried to convert the people and turn them away from idol worship. They were angry on him. They plotted to kill Mark. They tied a rope around his neck, dragged him along the streets and burned him. Mark gave up his life and died for the cause of the gospel. He died as a martyr. Until the point of his death, Mark was a faithful servant. He lived as a champion, died as a champion, and established churches. The third stage of Mark's life is Mark, the first author. God used Mark in a glorious manner. The Holy Spirit used Mark to write the Gospel of Jesus, which comes second in the New Testament, but indeed, Mark was the first Gospel to be written, and John Mark was its author. In the Gospel of Mark, God revealed His glory. In the Old Testament, Malachi was the last book to be written. It was the last time when God spoke, the last time when God gave an oracle to His people. After that, for the next 450 years, God was silent. There was no oracle from God. But after 450 years, God started to speak. He spoke through the Gospel of Mark. Malachi ended by saying, "There is a prophet who is to come. He is God's messenger, and he will come before the coming of the Lord." Mark started his gospel by saying, "As it was written in the prophets, the messenger has come. He will prepare the way for the Lord." And that messenger was John the Baptist. Where Malachi stopped, where Malachi paused, Mark resumed. In other words, God stopped speaking in Malachi, but God resumed speaking in Mark. God used John Mark to write this gospel, and God revealed His glory, and God spoke through the Gospel of Mark. Mark had a burden in his heart. He wanted to bring the Romans to salvation. The Romans believed in many gods. They were polytheistic people. Mark had the burden to reveal to them and prove to them who the supreme one true God was. So he wrote the gospel to the Romans. He wanted to prove Jesus as the one and supreme God. Now to the Romans, they would accept the other gods as one of their gods, but not as the supreme. But Mark took the challenge to prove that Jesus was the only true God. The Roman gods had a characteristic. They lorded over their subjects. They would boss around, they would take service. But Mark wanted to show Jesus different from the gods, different from the gods of the Romans. So in his gospel, Mark starts, "The gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God." He writes to the Romans, "This is the gospel of Jesus, God who became man, the Son of God." Read about him. Throughout the gospel, Mark proves that Jesus, God who came as man, served the people. He performed miracles. He healed all who came to him. He washed the feet of his disciples in humility. God, who came as man, served the people, unlike the Roman gods who took service. This was appealing to the Romans. Jesus said in Mark 10:45, "For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Jesus came as God to serve the people. By this, Mark showed that Jesus was superior to the Roman gods. The people believed Jesus first to be a man. They believed him to be a carpenter. They also believed him to be a prophet. But in the end, when Jesus was crucified on the cross, a Roman centurion saw Jesus and he testified, saying, truly this man is the Son of God. Let's read. Mark 15:39. So when the centurion who stood opposite him saw that he cried out like this and breathed his last, he said, "Truly this man was the Son of God." In his gospel, Mark proved to the Romans that Jesus is the Son of God, and with the evidence that a Roman centurion accepted that Jesus is the Son of God, he made the gospel more appealing to the Romans. God used Mark in a glorious way to be the first author of the Gospels, the first gospel writer, and the author who wrote the Gospels to the Romans to bring the Romans to salvation. So from the life of Mark, we can see he was a frightened youth at first, but he gave his life for Jesus, became a faithful servant. He established churches. He raised servants of God in the ministry, raised preachers, deacons, and bishops. Even till the point of his death, he stood boldly for the kingdom's cause, and he died as a champion, as a martyr. In the time of Mark, there were many who said Jesus was only a man. He was just a carpenter by profession. He was just a prophet. But Mark proved that Jesus was the Son of God, and he wrote a gospel for it. God glorified him, and his life is an example for us. Like Mark, we must take him as an example. We must not be ashamed of the gospel. Even in our age, people say that Jesus was a man, just a man, a good man, a saint, a teacher, a guru. Some say he is just a prophet. But we have an obligation to prove that Jesus is indeed the Son of God and God Himself. Mark was a champion because he proved this to the world through his gospel, and we have that in our hands. We now have an obligation in this age as youth to prove to the world that Jesus is indeed God. So the life of Mark teaches us to stand for Christ and live as a champion for Christ. Let us accept his example and live as champions for Christ. May God bless you through this short sharing. Amen.
Mark. John Mark. John is the Hebrew name, and Mark is a Greco-Roman name. Follower of Jesus Christ, friend and disciple of Peter, fellow worker of Paul, cousin and co-worker of Barnabas, author of Mark's Gospel. The Gospel of Mark is the second of the four canonical Gospels and one of the three synoptic Gospels. The Gospel teaches that from Jesus' baptism to his ministry, good news for human life, and also Jesus' death and resurrection. Mark the evangelist prayer. Loving and living Lord God, we praise and thank you for your follower, John Mark, and the author of Mark's Gospel. Thank you for Mark is the earliest gospel. When were the gospels written? He only has revealed first to the world that Jesus is the Messiah and Son of God through the gospel of Mark. Thank God for his gospel, which is one of the four pillars of the Bible. The global message of John Mark, mentioned in his gospel, Mark 1:15. The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Kalam niraiveritu. Devanude rajyam samivumaitu. Manandirumbi சுவிசேஷத்தை விசுவாசியுங்கள் என்றார். Thank you for his ministry that he was the first bishop of Alexandria and the first person to establish a Christian church in Africa. Praise God for Mark traveled with Barnabas to Cyprus for more mission work. 2 Timothy 4:11. Get Mark and bring him with you, for he is useful to me for ministry. Paul says, மார்க்குவை உன்னோடே கூட்டிக் கொண்டு வா, ஊழியத்தில் அவன் எனக்கு பிரயோஜனம் உள்ளவன். He became significant in the life of Paul and his ministry. Thank you for the symbol of Mark gospel is a lion. Reflect the lion of Judah. Lord God, thank you for the 7 major themes of Mark's gospel. The presentation of God, the kingdom of God, enacted Christology, theology of discipleship, mission in Mark, atonement and salvation, Mark's eschatology. The gospel reflects a sense of urgency, and immediately the word appears 41 times in Mark. Thank you for the Mark is mainly focused in his gospel, Jesus' death and suffering. Lord, once again, we thank you for the life of evangelist John Mark and his mission work and the gospel of Mark. Help us to understand the gospel of Mark thoroughly and make us true disciple and true worker for the sake of gospel. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Hallelujah.